Welcome. We're about to discuss the container object that helps you take faster decision, serving as a container for charts and other sheet objects. With the help of tabs and drop-downs, you can select objects you want to be displayed. Not just that, you can also add objects in the container that have different dimensions and expressions. You can group objects in a container by function, context, or both. Container objects give QlikView document designers a way to present multiple perspectives on a set of facts in a single screen. Let us see how you can create one of these. I have a business requirement to find out that which airline had the lowest number of flights delayed and canceled in the month of August. And for this, I'm creating a QlikView document, and I have already created a list box for month, a multi-box for the origin airport, carrier, and the day of week. And I have a current selections box which will show me the selections that I make. I also have a different sheet for the flight data where I have charts representing number of flights per carrier, flights delayed per carrier, flights canceled per carrier, and the number of flights per day. I can then go to my airline analysis document sheet, right-click anywhere in the blank space, New Sheet Object, Container, and select from the available objects to create a container. Let's say I select number of flights per carrier, number of flights delayed per carrier, flights per day, and flights canceled per carrier. Also, if you want to promote or demote any of the object, you can do so. Click on Apply and click on OK. This will create your container object. If you want, you can represent the container in the form of tabs so that one chart would be displayed at a time. Alternatively, you can go to the properties of the container, go to the presentation tab, and select the container type as grid. When you do so, you can represent all the chart objects all at once, and you may then go ahead and resize them as per your requirement. Once resized, you may then select the month from the list box, which in my case is August, and the origin airport would be Baltimore, Washington, which is what my business requirement is. Once selected, you will see the data in the chart with respect to the selection you have made, and you can notice your selections in the current selections box. You may then browse through flights delayed per carrier chart to find out that Mesa Airlines was the one with the lowest number of delayed flights. Similarly, when you browse through flights canceled per carrier, you would notice that again, Mesa Airlines was the one with the lowest number of flights that were canceled. Once you have concluded that Mesa Airlines is the one that has the lowest number of flights canceled and delayed in the month of August, you can then make a selection from the multi-box and see the number of flights per day for that selected airline. For example, on Saturdays, it had just one flight. Whereas on a different day, let's say Monday, it had two flights. So if you would notice that from just one single screen, you can do multiple analysis, see the data from different perspectives. For a different set of facts, you can draw various conclusions. If you would notice, container objects help you hold the charts and objects and will help you complete your analysis. Hope this video helped you gain insights into the tool and was helpful. Thank you.